We're going to be moving right into the game. Quidd limbering up his neck as he knows this is going to be a
this is
going to
be a fight.
Yeah. Also, a marathon. Good chance we're in for the long haul, folks.
Don't say game 10. Don't say that. I don't want to say
that. Oh, what's that? You want game 10?
Yeah, we haven't been having those for a hot minute, yo. Let's not do this.
Game 10? 10 timeouts? I'll do it.
I'm gone.
I'm out of there. If that's the case, I'm out of there.
I will solo commentate 10 games of timeouts.
You're a masochist.
I am a victim. It's just Stockholm syndrome. I love commentating timeouts, dude.
It's so they're intense, but they're draining. Anyways, something I totally forgot. Rob can hold Pac-Man's items and still use his gyro and laser.
They are, in fact, special moves.
Yeah.
So, I know that Sinji once sort of articulated it as Rob is a zoner that beats other zoners.
Yes, he 100% is, and it's not fair. Pac-Man does the same thing, but not as aggressive, not as hard as Rob does.
Whoa. I'm surprised Sinji got caught by that. And
how'd that not hit him?
What?
How'd that not hit him?
The down air?
I swear to you that one of those burn-ups in that jet definitely hit the sheep with walking cheese ball.
I think he was specifically going for the sour spot, though, so he misspaced it. You know what I mean? Because if he goes for the sweet spot, he gets hit right into the trampoline, bounces right back up.
Okay, you're right.
So I've seen that Robs will actually specifically try and aim for the sour spot of down air in order to edge guard against like a pack.
Okay, that makes sense.
Ooh. Wait, how did... I just told
so about
you!
That.
He's supposed to jump into the trampoline!
So
where did he go?
About that, Quidd just putting a whole hole in your logic.
Wait, where did he go? The trampoline was right there!
He didn't have enough time to grab the trampoline, you know? He
that's not how that works!
Oh my god, that worked!
There we go. That's okay. There.
See, your logic is there, but maybe he went... He DI'd away from the trampoline.
He DI'd away from the trampoline.
Okay.
I think because he was DI'ing towards the stage.
Okay.
He was drifting towards the stage.
That makes perfect sense. He kind of just shot his way past the trampoline. Oh, no.
Oh. I mean, technically, I guess that has the chance to cross up.
So.
Oh! Okay, that was smart as hell!
He went all the way down. For those of you who don't know what happened right there, Sinji went for the side B, and Rob just went,
no.
And took it. Sinji was put into lag and was so close to blast zone, he had nothing he could do. He just died.
Just kind of just bonk, put that away. So I just want to tell you something about Quidd's Rob, right? Quidd's Rob does not use down air. Does not use down throw.
I saw him kill with down throw earlier in bracket.
You didn't see that.
Oh! Wait, how did he grab that key?
Robot magnet hands.
The
robot got magnet hands. Don't think
it was
about
instant. And that key, the fact he caught that key was actually so big because that might have been a way for Sinji to take the stop. And right now, he's struggling. That's 174% on Quidd. And Sinji doesn't seem to have a real clue. He has to get a bell or something
and
like
there
that.
There he goes. As he does. I'm on to put a Quidd bypassing just the ledge disadvantage, say, and just pop his ass right back on stage like he's a Pikachu. Rob can do that. It's not really any way to contest Rob up there as Pac-Man.
Man, you know, I will say, I feel like it would be fun to deconstruct exactly frame by frame how Sinji ledge traps. The way that he, I can't.
Big damage.
I can't dwell on something as far off in the past as ledge trapping. He's not dead. Okay.
No.
But like Sinji's combos and overall, that was a brave upbeat. The fact that he was that far away, man, if he got down there, it would have been extremely difficult for him to hit the trampoline to recover.
Yeah, Popeye.
Whenever the gyro is there, you have to be careful. Rob is absolutely going to look for that. Not only is it like really reliable, it turns down tilt into a guaranteed kill confirm.
Yep.
But also, Robs think they're really cool when they do it. So
I mean, I'm not going to lie. That's probably like one of the few cool things that Rob does. And Quidd has been doing a lot of gyro shenanigans today. So I give him mad props for that because that was cool. That was pretty damn snazzy, if you ask me. Oopsies. Pretty damn snazzy.
Man, that's going to be game one for Quidd. He has gone all Rob this entire bracket.
The worst timeline.
He's not going to be a Rob main. He's not going to be a Rob main.
Let's hope. Anyways, game number two.
Listen, I don't want it, but it's like I can see him playing a lot more Rob in the future.
I can see him playing a lot more Rob.
Honestly,
but I don't think
I
see him.
Why I think he's playing Rob? Kamex.
Has he been struggling against Kamix?
He, last time, 2 weeks ago when they played, Kamix beat him 2-0, and then Quidd got the run back on him, and Quidd beat him 3-2. It was way too close.
Kamix is the Sonic player, correct?
Yes. So, I remember specifically after the set, Quidd was leaning back in his chair, defeated. And he had to fight Jen after, right? So he got the reset on Jen, but then he just ran out of steam, and Jen just ran the train on him. So I feel like he's playing Rob to probably, like, take the stress out of, like, playing PT against some of the harder characters like Sonic. Or maybe playing Rob to cover some bad matchup, because not even Pac-Man does well against Sonic.
Ooh, does it again!
And I will say, like, before I was like, oh, you gotta watch that down tilt. But, like, in that situation, he was watching out for down tilt. He was shielding.
Mm-hmm.
He was shielding.
It didn't matter.
And it didn't matter.
It didn't matter, man. All are equal in the eyes of Rob down tilt. Rob down tilt to shield, what do? You either hold that or you run, or you jump out of it. It's like Terry down tilt, but more dumb. The Terry down tilt, it'll tilt him first. But Rob's... Rob just said some tech situations. Actually, no, Terry's a lot more dumb than that. Can he die from this? No, he can't. Up throw wouldn't kill?
If Sinji didn't go for it, then it would not have killed.
Fair point. He would know. The apple all right. Will do it. Rob must be a doctor. Because that apple did send him away.
Oh, my God!
Are you kidding me?
Why is Quiz Rob cool? Why is Quiz Rob cool, bro? I can't believe I just called Rob cool on stream. Yo, somebody get me holy water. I must be possessed. That was cool.
Oh.
That was actually sick.
And he reflected the melon.
The presence
my
of mind to throw the gyro down there and then go for the spin.
The thing is, I feel like Quinn has very good reaction time.
Yes, he does. His reaction time is insane.
It's insane. And I feel like that's a Rob setup that you can really only do if you have godlike reaction time.
I agree.
Because committing to that side B if they don't get hit by the gyro is such a commitment.
I think he just knew. I don't even think of reaction. I think he just knew. But it's not like something you could wait for.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, at this point, I don't even know what goes on in the mind of this Rob player.
A button.
The inner machinations of his mind are an enigma.
A button. So look at that A button. Wait, no, that's not the A button I'm talking about. Do the big A button. Do the funny A button.
Do BB.
Oh, bye-bye.
Nah, he's dead. That's 2-0 currently. Yeah. I mean, he's in the lead.
Again, I want to point out, no down throw. No down throw for both those games.
You know, the funny thing is, I saw him earlier on. I forget who it was against. But he was getting, I think it was player four. He got a bunch of down. He got a bunch of grabs, and Rob grabbed. Despite the fact how good Rob's throws are, his grab is hilariously pathetic. He like goes,
and then just misses, stumbles a little bit, then gets back.
And the actual grab box for it is like in his chest.
Really, it's small.
It's small. It is much smaller
for
than you think.
For a character with such a small grab, you think, where does gyro go?
It's in a better place now. Back in his pocket.
But, like, for a character with such a small grab.
See right there? You saw he went for that. He went for that grab, and it just, like, whiffed.
But it doesn't have a lot of recovery. It's, like, from the way, I feel like a way to, like, nerf Rob, just going, like, completely off tangent, the way to nerf Rob would be, like, give him more lag on his grab. It's, like, not, like, tether recovery type of lag, but, like, just more lag.
In general, they try to avoid giving characters more lag, and which I agree with. I think that that's actually a really scummy way of balancing.
I think it's honest.
I mean, like, listen, I understand it's like, okay, he should have had more lag to begin with. But it's kind of mean to people who play the character. Like, when a move's knockback gets decreased or something like
mean
that.
Mean to Rob.
It's one thing. What?
Mean to Rob. Rob needs to be bullied. I know Quiz Rob is sick, but Rob? Nah, bully Rob. Bully Rob. Bully
I mean, you Rob. Know the actual way to nerf Rob.
Yeah, Nair.
What? No.
What?
No. Rebuff Palutena.
Ah!
That's the reason why he wasn't that much of a presence in the meta for so long.
Yeah, because Palutena's just caught him.
Yeah, that's what it is. So if you hate Rob, beg Nintendo to rebuff Palutena.
I mean, I still think Palutena is mad work on Rob.
I mean, yeah, but not enough people are playing Palutena now.
That's true. They all think she sucks, which is cap.
She doesn't suck. They were kind of
brutal with those nerfs. That is true. But
they were no. I'm saying that I feel like they didn't know how good they had it before the nerfs.
They had it. Good.
They're like now
top
this
three character, or debatably no, top three.
I think she was top two.
Nah, Joker and Pikachu exist.
I genuinely think that pre-patch Palu was probably better than Joker. Joker hasn't really gotten nerfed. But Joker's been falling off.
We'll get back to that later. I mean, Quidd is actually down. This.
What
the
are you
hell?
Talking? I just remembered it.
Oh, he tried to throw a Hydra now. Huh?
Sinji, please. There are children.
Okay.
You have children at home waiting for you.
But we don't need to witness a murder.
Oh, no. That was actually so much damage.
A very different game.
I feel like one of the reasons why this game is different is because Sinji managed to set the pace of the match in a way that he had not in the previous games.
Yeah.
Not only did he get a lead, but he's actually able to play to it with a longer stage, you know, just being town and city. He's able to run away more effectively, and on top of that, he's just like forcing Quidd to approach and punishing him for approaching as well.
Yes, he really is. No, it's like, it's one of those games where it's like, you know, I'm approach, you're making the opponent approach, and they don't really want to do that. Especially like Rob. Rob, he had decent approach options, like forward air and air are also really good. But Sinji with the fruit in hand, kind of stuffs those out. And also Sinji's reaction is also really good, too.
The Hydrant got hit and he's just like, nope.
No, I'm out. Oh, caught the gyro!
That was actually so smart. He threw the gyro down so that he could actually get the grab. Oh. Oh, that time he actually wasn't anticipating Sinji getting caught by the gyro. Otherwise, he would have gone for one of those hard commitment off-the-stage kills like we'd seen him go for before. That's
sub-by.
That's... All right, we have a game four. Okay. Which means that we have a game five, which means that we have a game 10.
I don't know.
What's that? You wanted to go to sleep tonight?
Did I say that?
You implied it when you looked down when I said game 10.
let's just say, the Encore curse hasn't been going on, right? The Encore curse was broken after quarantine? After quarantine? Where it's like a lot of our locals.
It was after Quidd. Like, honestly, when Quidd came and really started with League of Dominance, nobody's taking Quidd to game 10.
That's true.
Like, it's kind of what it is. Although maybe we will be proven wrong.
I mean, even when Quidd wasn't showing up at Encore, like, we still didn't get Quidd.
That's
go!
True.
All right, so smaller stage this time. Probably to Rob's favor.
The gyro. Okay, there it is.
So Rob got some arms, man. That gyro went high up.
Anti-gravity gyro.
I believe it. Bonk. Okay.
Ooh. By the way, that is another part of the matchup that if Rob is up there, he can up air through the hydrant and still hit Pac-Man when he's, you know, trying to use it at a disadvantage.
Multi hits. One of the few multi-hits that, few ways that multi-hits work great in Ultimate, because other times multi-hits kind of are less to be desired, unless it's certain characters.
I mean, I do believe that multi-hits like scale better with rage, right?
Yes, they do.
That is one of the other benefits. That's why Rob up there when he
is. No, Rob is too happy for that.
I bet Sinji wishes up smash was a multi-hit. It is actually.
Yeah. Choosing not to roll this to get everything into that?
Yeah.
Oh, what was Quidd thinking?
No fancy feat necessary. Sinji now with a lead. Let's see if he can recreate that game three success and actually, you know, build this lead into something. Something really insurmountable.
75% already on the board. I like the idea. Ooh.
He definitely would have looked really cool if it had worked.
I agree.
He has Bell in hand. Yep. Now he has Bell physically in his hand. That should be Death Bell up on the platform. Yeah, that's going to do it.
Well, can Quidd get a Rob stock?
I believe that was at a tomahawk,
like an empty land grab.
Yes.
Yeah, so that was a really good call out on Quidd's part. Did he have Bell in hand when he did that?
If he did, he's get.
Oh man!
Don't scare me like that, Quidd. Because like you're going for that, like well, Rob's only going for that when it kills. So like you going for that is, you're bold.
See, that's how you know he's not a Rob main. He didn't kill. A real Rob main would have made that kill at 38%. He would have like whispered the secret passcode.
Jesus Christ, he's dead. He's dead.
That reminds me of like when Sinji was playing against PK Chris. You know, PK Chris had this big lead, and then he put him off stage, and he just like kept, you know, hitting him out there over and over again, and finishing off with a forward smash. That's kind of exactly what Quidd did right there. Just exhausted Sinji of his resources. And now this is actually looking really dire for Sinji. You know, he's made an amazing loser's run to get to this point. But all of a sudden, this is possibly his last stock of the tournament. Already at 67, and Quidd is just sitting pretty here. Not scared at all.
Not at all, man. He doesn't need to worry about... Okay, now he has to worry about something. So Sinji can rack up this percent. We already know. Rob, my god. Rob's combo.
He willingly put himself that deep out there. I think he might have Galaxian in hand.
Yeah, that's big. Or charged up.
Yeah, that's definitely at these lower percentages what he's going to be looking for. Yeah, trying to put up all that pressure. But really good stuff from Quidd, knowing not to fall victim to it. He does have a Pac-Man himself. That is worth remembering.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does.
Okay. Oh, man. 97%. He's actually really scary.
What is he doing?
He's pulling out all the stops right now. Abusing the stage, abusing Pac-Man's own resources, and now Sinji at 120% trapped in the corner.
You're crazy. Fed up smash read.
I don't think it's that crazy because if it
It's crazy because Pac-Man can still F smash you. That's the final smash. It didn't kill, but it definitely put the fear in him.
That's true.
And when there's fear in you, you start to play a little bit too safe. When you need to go a little bit more ballistic.
Yeah.
But just a ballistic in a certain type of way. That up smash, not the ballistic we're looking for.
Oh, that was hiding
so in his face.
That was also questionable DI. That almost did Quidd in right there. He's at 131 versus 138.
Oh!
Yeah, gyro.
But gyro just went the other
way.
Yeah, got knocked back because of the Rob laser. This is actually so scary right now. That dash attack was beautiful, getting right past, knowing that he wanted to be picking an option like that.
But the back end attack!
Is that going to do it? It does, just barely enough. Sinji keeping his tournament run alive right now. We're moving into game five. So we're going to have game 10.
Huh? Stop that. That was a dangerously close game number five.
That was
dangerously close.
Really, really close.
Quidd could not close out that last stock. All he needed was a grab. All he needed was a grab to close the final stock.
But it's also like, when you think about the way that Sinji was getting his openings, it was the kind of calculated, very specific call-outs that he was realizing the habits of when Quidd was trying to pull out, you know, all of his projectiles, trying to set up his wall, and he was breaking through. Sinji was absolutely the aggressor in the last, like, you know, last 20% of that game, and it worked out really well for him.
So I will say Quidd definitely threw that. I wouldn't say he threw, but it fell out of hands when he started, when he did that up smash. Because before he had that. That was his game to lose, 100%. Interesting use of Rob side B. Bonk. This is a scrap right now, and I actually like it. You don't really see that too much. You wouldn't expect a scrap in this matchup with these two characters, with the history that these characters are known for.
At the same time, the scrap isn't maybe that surprising, purely because, as we said before, Rob is a zoner that beats other zoners.
Yes,
so Sinji is kind of the one pressured to really make stuff happen.
But it's like, so what exactly does Rob have that makes him beat zoners? He has great frame data. He has a huge box. Huge hitbox with a Nair. And he has gyro and he has laser, right?
Yeah, the laser Pac-Man. Is also the fact that the laser is transcendent. Is
yes.
Huge.
So it goes to Pac-Man Hydra.
Miss
input?
That must have been a miss input. I can't imagine.
He read that?
Yeah. It could also have been that he was trying to punish like a ledge jump, but no, the gyro was there. I'm pretty sure that was a miss input. Aggressive attack air. Yeah.
I'm actually really curious.
I love the fact that Sinji is putting his hydrant right at the ledge there. You know, because it seems to be preventing that the prime real estate position for that for the Rob's gyro.
It really does. There we go. Finally getting
it. He missed it again.
Yep, that DI. That's it. Not doing justice for him. Apple not killing it yet. It would have killed Rage, but
I actually don't know if they're an item, so I don't know if they stack with Rage. I can check on that later, though. Like, Peach's turnips don't stack with Rage. I don't know whether or not Pac-Man fruit stack with Rage. I'll check this in.
Oh! That was smart. That was smart.
Oh, my God. That was brilliant. I was like, talking in hushed tones because I didn't think we were going to have, like, a Polaris breach right there. For those of you who don't know, a Polaris breach is when a great white shark, like, attacks a seal from underneath.
Oh, there's a name for that? I thought it was just called a sneak attack. An ambush.
A shark strike. I don't know. I didn't think there was a name for it.
I mean, the name is Polaris Breach, which is pretty cool, right?
Yeah, it's an interesting name.
Oh, that was...
There we go.
Gatsby, take note.
Gatsby, take note. Nah, Gatsby, like, nah, that's too lame for me. I can't do that. I got a strike. Gatsby got a strike, man.
But Sinji not letting that really deter him. He's putting on the damage. He's putting on the pressure. And with Bell in hand, with the right positioning, forward smash, is that actually going to do it?
Nice. He's able to get a charge. He's able to throw it after Rob down. Okay. Note taken.
Like, this is the sort of mastery of a character. The fact that Sinji not only managed to get the Bell, but knew that he had to charge the forward smash and knew exactly how long he could charge it for.
And now he's in the lead. Look at that, 71%. Got a lot of ground to cover.
Also, I'm loving the way he's using charging fruit to sometimes sort of beat out the gyro. It's very subtle, but it's being impactful nonetheless. Man, we are on the brink of a bracket reset. Weak backer is not going to do it. I don't think there was any option that Sinji had that could kill at that point. But look at this, 144%. If you are Quidd, one of your few paths to victory at this point is crazy stupid Rob stuff off stage.
Literally.
He has gyro in hand. He's looking for it. Ooh. That's his dream. That's what he's doing. Yeah, Sinji knows he's looking for it, too.
Looking for a Z-drop Nair. Sinji not falling into any of the Rob stuff. Quidd can get a hand on him.
Key. I love this. I love the idea of taking out the key. Just and we have
a reset. Jesus.
There it is. Game 10 incoming, buddy.
No, stop saying that. You're going to speak it into existence.
I already did, dude. I'm sorry, but like, I've been cursed with prophecy. I made out with Apollo that one time.
Oh, my goodness. And now here it happens.
That's a shout out to all you people out there who are familiar with ancient Greek mythology.
I love Greek mythology.
Yeah. Apollo would just, like, gift prophecy to all of his, like, BFs and GFs. And then all of them, or, like, 90% of them would be like, I hate this.
Like, I can predict things now. It's not fun.
Yeah. Classic, you know, Cassandra. So he's like, hey, babe, what if I gave you prophecy? And she's like, okay, I still don't want to go out with you. And then he's like, then no one will ever believe you. And that's her living nightmare.
Oh, that sucks.
All right.
Here we go.
The Rob
Quidd PT.
Yep. This is so we're going to be getting a very different flavor of a set two of Grand Finals. And if you're Sinji, you got to re-crank the gears. You know, he was very aggressive against that Rob, pretty much because the playstyle demanded it. But this time around, I think we maybe are going to see Sinji take a little bit more of a passive role if Quidd gives him the chance.
I don't think he will. Well, it's hard. It's hard to say if he will or not, because, like, PT has, like, Squirtle, I would say, has an easier time getting in a Pac-Man. Squirtle's so nimble.
That's huge!
Jesus.
I love that. Throwing out an option that can basically frame trap the Pokemon Switch.
You would figure you'd throw a Rising Dare. Maybe that could work. But I don't think up air frame traps Pokemon Switch. It's more like he had the right idea. He had the read. Oh, dear.
That's only going to be a back air, but that's some good stage positioning. Oh. Sinji's just looking so hot right now. It feels like Quidd can't even get anything started. Mm-mm. Granted, once Quidd does get something started, we know what he does.
Yeah, he kind of goes in.
There's a reason why Sinji is playing so carefully. Oh, God. He's dead.
There we go. Frame trap.
Sinji's dying first. Oh!
She was gonna wait. Oh! That was cute. That was cute.
Oh, man.
Had the read. She was gonna play it low, play it safe. This is... This is actually really intense. I wonder who's going to lose this stock first.
I already said it was going to be Sinji like a half a minute ago. Oh, we're actually seeing Zard come out. That's kind of surprising. I mean, I guess the extra survival.
Kill throw.
That's all that was the reason why. Also, I have been cursed with the gift of prophecy. I remember before I was just like, I have like a 70% accuracy rate when it's like, I'm like, this person's going to die now before they take the stock. I said that.
Yeah. It's right. Coming through now.
How did he not die?
Black magic. I honestly, I have no idea how he able to like, skedaddle his way through all that.
He freaking opened up the Necronomicon in order to survive that.
And he knew to tech that?
What Dark Lord did you sacrifice virgins to in order to have this survivability that you do? He was gifted immortality, man.
Quid. I mean, with how much he's surviving, it probably was immortality.
All right. Okay. That was
a little bit with that F smash.
It was a brave choice. Mm-hmm. Did you see that?
Yep.
He forward tilted him, and then he got pushed back into the grab range.
Awareness.
Oh man. All right. I feel like it feels like Quid kind of just needed a little bit of time to resettle. You know, shake off the Rob webs. If you will.
Some time to, like, you know, use that brain a little bit more.
Are you implying that Rob does not require brain?
I mean, there's that big ol' A button. And that big ol' A button does some things. Especially in the neutral position. A lot of people not used to that big ol' A button. Now, Ivysaur got two big ol' A buttons. Easier to deal with than Rob's.
Again, I'm honestly loving the way that Quidd has been incorporating Charizard more into his overall gameplay.
Because remember, around the time when Cormus opened back up, Quidd didn't really use Zard. Huh?
That was amazing. Amazing use
but
of
he
the
had
upbeat.
Even a grab.
He upbeat right before, and then... Don't worry about it.
No, I have to worry about it, because that was wild. How did he... Yo,
I think it spawns frame one, and then I think he kind of eventually Fox shifted into it. This is why we need replays and a green screen behind us, which is coming soon, folks. Apparently.
Oh, that's hype. I want to see a flare blitz, but I know Quidd. He's not gonna do that.
I think he's gonna.
Oh, even better, just back air him.
Oh, man. And Sinji started off that game so well. But then it got time to actually close out the stock. And Quidd was like, I think I'm not going to let you this time.
Is he about that? I have this butt friend of mine here named Charizard. He does spend. Game number 7?
Yeah, I will also say another part of one of the advantages of being in the winner's side of Grand Finals is that the person who's in losers has just had to play a ton of games.
Yeah.
Like think about I don't know the exact number of games on stream that Sinji's had to play almost consecutively, but you can kind of see it in his face. He's maybe a little bit slowing down. It's almost 11 o'clock on a Thursday. It can be so hard to keep yourself in the mental space that's required to keep up with Quidd.
Quidd is such a strong player, too. And all the things he's making are really calculated. I know Sinji definitely has the stamina for this. So, like, you got to understand, he's been playing for a while. He's not used to these situations. These aren't anything new to him.
I do think I agree. I tend to agree. But right now, it feels like Quidd has a freshness in his step that Sinji's kind of lacking.
Maybe it just Sinji needs time to adjust to the speed G. Who knows?
That is also, keep in mind, he was down 2-0 against the Rob.
Yes, he was.
And then he figured out what he needs to do and got the reverse 3-0. And I mean, also, we're going to have a game 10, so we're going to have a back and forth.
Stop saying game 10. Stop saying those words. I don't want to believe. But if Sinji wins this game, I'm going to have to believe.
I think Sinji's going to win this game.
It could happen.
And then from there, it's just a matter of time.
Oh, my God. What?
That's okay, never mind.
That was ballsy. I don't know. What was the reasoning behind that?
He tried to hit a button that wasn't the button that came out, if I'm going to be honest.
Dare?
No. Ooh. I mean, dare is free damage if it lands, right?
Yes, it is. Free damage, you know? Maybe it could.
Oh, wait, no. He also gets hit, though, if he does dare.
Yes.
Because Pac-Man will pop up, and because he just got hit, he will not go up the ledge.
Oh.
He will always go past it when you see Pac-Man, like, do that bounce up back down.
I do not know. Jesus Christ, this is scary. Pac-Man at disadvantage against Ivysaur. Not a place he wants to be.
And he's still struggling to find this kill. This is a beyond max rage Ivysaur. 170%, and Sinji is really struggling. A grab at this point will kill him. I think grab from anywhere on stage will kill, because down throw is
or you can just whip him with these vines with an F in the forward air. Quidd Pac-Man, the Quidd PT something else, man.
Okay.
Hadou's still not doing the job. Whoa!
Yeah, I love it when he does
that. That high speed orange not doing it either.
Nice,
the
good
stanky
job.
Stanky leg will do it.
Is that what we're calling
I'm
it?
I'm calling it the stanky leg. The way he put that out there, just whamp.
Stanky leg.
Through the stanky leg.
I like that. Frame trapping the air dodge, getting a nice 57% onto Squirtle. You know, a comeback at this point, we've actually seen Sinji do it already. He had a 3-stock-to-1 comeback. He already did a 3-stock-to-1 comeback.
I'm not counting it out for Sinji. It's anyone's game at this point. It's still anyone's game.
I think that this right here is going to say a lot, whether or not he's going to be able to deal with this Ivysaur. For the most part, once the Ivysaur comes out, Sinji has kind of been struggling to especially get kills. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't think he's killed the Ivysaur once.
No. Whew. That was a little boost from the water, too, with that F smash.
Ivysaur, on the other hand.
Ivysaur.
No problem killing. We have another up 2-0. Quidd right now, one game away from winning the entirety of the tournament. Sinji having this crazy loser's run, losing to Gatsby kind of early on, and already managing to upset the bracket once. Question is he going to be able to adapt? He needs to win 3 games in a row. And this is going to be, even if he wins this next game, the next two have to be on Quidd's counterpick.
Yes, they do, which is going to be rough because he's playing the PT. Yeah. It's not the Rob anymore, man. It's not the Rob. It's the PT. This is Quidd's pride and true.
Sinji kind of switching right now. Let's see what changes, what adaptations he can make. I think one of them is maybe don't side beat.
Yeah,
that's
still I'm wondering about that side.
I'll ask him later. I'm pretty sure it was a misinput.
Yeah, that cost him.
I also think it was a misinput because it felt like Sinji was kind of demoralized after it.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Sinji is, as a player, you know, he has very good mentality, but he definitely gets really frustrated when there's something that's outside of his control that ends up messing it up. Like, if he has a controller problem or, you know, any type of external thing, it can be really frustrating for him. You know, he spends so much time in the lab perfecting things, and then he goes out into the field, and it's something that was never in his control that ends up making things mess up for him. It can definitely, that's, like, one of the only things that I know can put him on television.
Okay, that makes a lot of sense. But I think, you know what I think that savvy was? I think that savvy from that game was kind of just like an epic option. It's like, screw it, let me see if this works.
But it may be, that's really out of character for Sinji, so it might not be it. But who knows?
Yeah, but we're kind of in a mirrored situation to what we saw in that game, too. Sinji up by quite a bit, but it's the Ivysaur he's facing down, and he needs to find a way to get this kill. Last time around, he ended up overextending and dying for it. Can he actually take this stock without losing his own first?
Who knows? The way he's playing right now, he's definitely very poised to take the stock first. Now it's Zard, and anyone can die here.
Yeah, we now have Zard, which... the extra weight is going to be helpful, but at the same time, he has a larger frame, and the neutral is probably a little bit...
Nice. Oh, up smash. No. The cat that jump away.
Yeah, don't forget, you can't jump against Zard. Oh! If he had waited just a little bit longer, I think he would have gotten pushed along with it, and maybe we could have had some snazzy combos. How is he not dead?
Ah, there we go. Back air right into the neck. Jesus Christ, that must hurt. 2 feet right into the back of your neck? Jesus. I'm trying to get the damage off. Nice get out of shield. Into the back air. Big damage coming out.
Ooh, and here comes the Ivy. You know, it feels like Sinji, for the most part, has been playing pretty well against the Ivysaur in terms of getting his damage, in terms of, like, you know, abusing Ivysaur's, you know, kind of lackluster disadvantage state.
So,
but then, once he gets to the point where he needs to actually be finishing off the stock, then it feels like, I don't know whether it's that Quidd goes into overdrive or Sinji kind of puts his pedal on the brakes, because it doesn't matter how much Sinji's been ahead this entire set. It's always the one to take it first.
Jesus Christ, and he knew. I understand why he air dodged right there, because usually, like, you know, most PTs, they go for the up in that situation.
I think he tried to air dodge the platform. The platform was right there. I think he wanted to air dodge the platform.
Okay, that makes it. Quidd. He does play the neutral really well against Quidd's Ivysaur, but it's finding the kills that he's not having an easy time doing.
Yeah, that's where we are now. Oh, I stand corrected.
Let me just eat my freaking words, bro. Sinji is a different man.
Listen, it doesn't work until it does.
Yeah.
What I feel like that's a lot of Sinji's Pac-Man plays. You're like, what is he doing? Like, what angle is he coming at here? And then it finally works, and you're like, oh.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, day.
Yeah, you kind of just look at it for like, oh, shit. It worked.
Ooh.
Right. He wouldn't have died, but that was a still scarce sleep. I don't want to be on the ledge of Sinji Pac.
Oh, man. All right. One stock apiece here. Sinji is in the red. He's been dying really early at those ledges. Let's see if he can avoid it this time around. Dodging that out forward smash is really pivotal.
Oh, my God. Okay, it was not the stronger hit, but... I principally try to get that back air out and punish that.
Where are you going?
Yo.
Oh, that's not going to be able to do it just yet. But Sinji at 148%. He's stuck off stage. Needs to find a way past this Ivysaur. He's not quite able to find his way back to neutral still, even now. 155%. Trapped at the ledge. Dodges the forward.
Another F smash.
Oh, and all of a sudden, now that he's back to neutral, this is where things can actually get pretty scary if you are Quidd. That bell in hand, if the bell connects, I think regardless of stage positioning, that will be the kill. Quidd is aware of it.
That's massive, but have to be careful. Can't whiff or grab.
All right, now Sinji's going to need to create some distance, get another bell charged up. I think that's kind of his path to victory.
Yeah, the fair will indeed take it.
All right.
There goes my chance of getting a game.
All right, so thank God